Welcome everyone to a Pentecostals of Peterborough devotional. Today we will be looking at the subject of the Holy Ghost. So my first scripture, if you would like to follow along, would be Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. But ye shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me in both Jerusalem and Judea and Samaria and to the uttermost part of the earth. The Holy Ghost is something that is essential and something that as a Pentecostal is a core doctrine of our faith. It is something that God has given us, but it is not only a gift, it's one of the greatest gifts that God has given man, that he has given to all of us to experience. Not just something for one of us or some of us or a select few of people, but it was for everyone. In Acts chapter 2, starting in verse 1, when the day of Pentecost arrived, they were all together in one place, and suddenly there came a sound like a sound like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. And divided tongues as a fire appeared to them and rested upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. In this situation, every single one of them that was in that room received the gift of the Holy Ghost. Men, women, children, whoever was there, God was willing to give the Holy Ghost if they were open to it. And it is the same today. The Holy Ghost is for everyone. It crosses racial barriers. It crosses every single barrier that you could think of. Any barrier of sin, anything, doesn't matter. If you come to God with a repentant heart, the Holy Ghost is for you. Further on in Acts chapter 2, Peter, after the first people received the Holy Ghost, they stumbled out into the streets. And people are asking, what was going on with these people? And Peter stood up and preached to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you and to your children, and for all who are far off, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to himself." And God is calling everyone to himself. So if you're watching this today and wondering, is this Holy Ghost that I've read in the Bible for me? Is this experience for me? Is this something that I can experience, that God wants to give to me? The answer is a resounding yes. The Holy Ghost is something that God gives to help us live in this world and the essential power for when he calls his home for us to be caught away. It is something that God gives us and speaks through us that we cannot control, that we cannot determine what we speak or what we say, but is something that God speaks through us. I found this interesting study from a few years ago that was done by the University of Pennsylvania, and they studied brain activity from people in a church service. First, they studied their brain activity when they were singing and worshiping, and then they looked at the brain activity when they were speaking in tongues. And what they found was that when people were singing or talking, the part of your brain that works when you're speaking and talking, they could see the brain activity. They could see people thinking and forming thoughts and talking. But when they were speaking in tongues, there was very little brain activity going on in that part of the brain where the speaking and thought process happens. And so their conclusion was that something else had to be going on. It wasn't from that person's mind, it wasn't from those person's thoughts that was producing the words coming out, but it was a spirit inside of them that was speaking out and crying out to God. And that is an experience that God wants all of us to have. He wants us all to be filled with his Spirit. He wants us all to come and experience the gift that he has given us. From the very beginning of the world, God wanted a relationship with each and every one of us. He wanted a relationship with every person that has walked this earth. And from the very beginning, after man fell, God was looking for a way to get back and have a relationship. And it was finally fulfilled when he could send back the Holy Ghost after he died on the cross, so that each and every one of us, he could live inside and be with us everywhere we go, always and forever. Before the Holy Ghost came back, the people could only experience God very few times in a very limited way. But when the Holy Ghost fell, each and every one of us could take God with us wherever we go. When you go to work and you're struggling at work, God would be with you. When you go home and your home life is not the way you want it to be, God would be there if you have and are filled with the Holy Ghost. So the Holy Ghost is something that I hope each and every one of you that is watching this at some point in your life make up the decision to find a place and ask God, this is something that I want to experience. This is something that I want in my life. Something that I need to experience. I've tried other things. I've tried everything else in my life to make a difference and nothing has helped. But I can guarantee you, this will help. This will make the difference.